Snapshot about what is AI today and what can be taken into account for Mauritius. So today the technology effects are all accelerating. Whatever it is on smartphone, on social media, on internet, on autonomous vehicles, cyber security. But if there is one area which is really giving, let's say, some momentum today, it's artificial intelligence. Why? Because there is a combination of management and acquisition of big data with the combination of very high speed of communication. And therefore, this is rapidly expanding the client capability. The client have camera, is always on voice and video, has local interaction, and wants continual feedback. For that, there is a high profile application, mobile vision, IP camera, robotics, drone, automotive, augmented reality, virtual reality. And you can see that indeed the amount of megabit or gigabit is increasing day after day. Today for your GPS it's 5 megabit. Tomorrow for your edge video, let's say streaming, it's 0.9 gigabit. And the self-driving car will basically use 25 gigabit per hour. A big change in the way of managing speed and capacity of memory. So let's take two examples which are maybe at the two extremes. The automotive, the most sophisticated one, and the IoT. And indeed, you may not read everything from the back of this room, but you know, this car, which is an ADAS, that means assisted driver assistance system, and the full autonomous car will be full of radar, camera, and sensors. So this makes it very complex. I can summarize it very quickly by saying, indeed, the car, let's make the two, take the two comments. Think about a self-driving car, it's effectively a data center on wheels, or a self-driving electric car is basically a computer on wheels with a big battery and a bunch of digital eyes and data to analyze. So that's where the artificial intelligence is making full sense. Now, let's go back to the most simple one. Most simple one is the IoT. But the IoT has many applications. The smart fitness, the smart city, the smart car, the smart healthcare, the smart home. And you can decline within, let's say, all these key items, the help to healthier lives, the reduce of traffic congestion, the reduce of emission, the empowerment of patient, and the help for physicians to monitor and diagnose, and obviously the smart home that are happening more and more. But you know, this artificial intelligence is built on also on hardware. It is not just software. Indeed, the building block of IoT is based on sensors and actuators, on brain, on communication in interface. The motion MEM, accelerometers, gyroscope, the environment sensor, humidity, pressure, temperature, the microphone, the touch, the proximity, the image sensor. So all of that allow, I may say, to make it very intelligent. The brain will be a low-power microcontroller. The low power is key. You need to, let's say, to be able to work with a very low power consumption to be able to manage for a long time, let's say, the IoT. And the ultra-low power connectivity is key. Now, let's look at the effect of artificial intelligence. Because if you look at from a long time ago on the labor productivity and so on, whatever from the steam machine to internet and starting basically 2015 on artificial intelligence, you can see that there is indeed a kind of very nice inflection in terms of not so much of labor productivity, but on personalization and quality. That's where the artificial intelligence makes a difference. And the impact of AI on industry is quite significant. Here you have what is the baseline in percentage of growth, 8.4, 7.5, 6.2, and what is going to bring the emergence of artificial intelligence in the growth of the GDP. So, let's look at now at the Mauritian AI strategy and imperative. This is not an exhaustive list. I'm trying to show that there is five key areas where we can really do something. Healthcare, manufacturing, financial services, ICT, multimedia and entertainment, and many others. On the one of healthcare, which is very key for everybody, it's that reason why I put it first here. The healthcare sector in Mauritius is 4.4% of the GDP, with a growth rate of 6.1, and there is 20 doctors basically per 10,000 inhabitants. But you can see that, you know, the artificial intelligence will bring a lot on assisted robot surgery. In the US, 30% of the surgery today are basically done with robotics, and this will come gradually to many countries in the world. This will help to have rapid, precise, and advanced diagnosis, genomic analysis and autocorrective medication, and improved treatment for cardiovascular, oncology, and diabetes. So, healthcare will be at the core of the artificial intelligence, and you can see that in many countries developing very quickly. The other one is on financial services. We are a major center for financial services, 11.9%, growth rate at 5.5, and obviously, robot advisory, credit rating, automated customer support, security and fraud busting, regulatory compliance, all of that will be able to be done through artificial intelligence quicker and smarter. The improved speed of operation, the customer-centric services, and the reduced cost of operation will result from such introduction. The same on manufacturing. On manufacturing, this is key. This is where artificial intelligence has been starting from automatization, robotics, and today, a key branch of computer science, artificial intelligence. And therefore, while it is 13.3%, but employ almost 98,700, you can see that Internet of Things, AI automated machine and robot control, smart manufacturing, augmented reality, will provide the key element and tools to be sure that industry can move and still get efficiency, better yield, better capability of competing, and better competitivity. And on the ICT, that's the area where indeed there is the ultimate application of artificial intelligence on natural language processing, speech recognition, computer vision. This is where artificial intelligence is a real computer science technology, where, let's say, you can accumulate, have reasoning, have synthesis of information, and react. So, opportunity to really even rebrand local BPO, and application will be decision-making, predictive analysis, language processing. Many things can be done through the ICT, which is a key industry employing 16,000 people in Mauritius. And to be a bit provocative, I use, let's say, media and entertainment, mostly because I have also the movie industry in mind and the cinema industry, where we had a few weeks ago a very good success in this activity, which is also having 2,000 people working in the movie industry. The contribution to the GDP is rather small at the moment, but I believe that the artificial intelligence for whatever image processing, imaging, well, virtual reality, gaming, for science fiction, of image movie, all of that will provide to the cinema industry and the multimedia at large the opportunity really to do something different and to make a step function. So, in other words, electronics have been meeting the industry needs, but electronics and artificial intelligence are now answering the society call. This is a big difference. Electronic was addressing the requirement of the professional with the PC, the mainframe, many, let's say, the fax machine at the time. Today, it is answering the demand of the customer, of the consumer. So, EDB is going to try to position Mauritius to be sure that we create all the conditions to be sure that AI will be a pervasive, let's say, technology that will go to all the sectors, and within our free mandate here, we'll try to be sure with all the ministries and all the stakeholders, the banks, the association, the manufacturing, and so on, to make it efficient in Mauritius. And that concludes my presentation. Thank you.